Hey, it's Saturday night, and if I got a special for you, this is almost too good of a special. I really don't want to take 20% off of my rods here, but we're going to do 20% off the Angler West Trout and Kokanee rods, the 8-foot and the 9'6" versions here. Show them to you real quick. This is the 9'6" rod. And I've got this Lexa 300 on here just to show you, because people ask me what size reel I'd recommend for this rod. You get the 300 size and the 100 size. Basically, this 300 Lexa right here, it balances on this rod just almost perfectly. All right, there you go. So now you could put a 100 on here and it would be just fine. And for trolling, you know, maybe balance isn't as crucial as would be if you're on a casting rod. But with this 300, you know, it's got more line capacity, which can be a good thing. But also, then you've got another reel that maybe you could use for big salmon. You could put that 300 on this 9'6" salmon trolling rod and, you know, troll 16 ounces of lead and the big flashers and all that. So it's just another, you know, awesome reel to have. And I think on this particular rod, I think it's the right way to go. There is, on the other, the 8-foot version here, this is basically the same rod, but it's a scaled down 8-foot version. I've got the 100 size Lexa on there, line counter, which balances really well for that. So if you want my recommendation, the 100 size, like the Lexa 100 on the 8-foot and the Lexa 300 on the 9.5-foot. Now, in my opinion, and it's just my opinion, the only reason anyone would want an 8-foot rod like this is if the 9.5 didn't exist. You know, I think the 9.5 is awesome. You know, these are my babies here. But the 8-foot is just something that some people prefer. They're asking for them, so I went ahead and had them built. And they're great rods. They're just 8 feet long. I just like the little longer length. I was using this rod just in California just a couple days ago. We were trolling with it and down with a downrigger, the 9.5-footer here, and it's so nice in a downrigger, the way it sets up and how sensitive the tip is. We could actually see we're using small lures and small little dodgers, and you could actually see that lure working even with no dodger. Like, we had a crippler out with nothing on it, and you could see, even bent over in the downrigger, the pretty tight bend in it, you could actually see that lure working because this tip is so sensitive. So I think these rods are just awesome. And the final, 6 guides are wrapped in bright green, which makes the tip of the rod a lot easier to see in the dim light and against the dark water and the trees and all that. So now, one thing about these rods I want to show you, if you can get a good look at that, it's a little rougher on the surface, the texture of this here, as compared to, you just grab, this is the rod we got here in the shop. This is a, you know, cheap Chinese combo here. But that's all smooth. You're probably used to seeing a lot of really smooth rods like that. Well, this cheap rod was the same, basically, texture as this rod when it came out of the oven, but it's been sanded. So when rods are built, they're baked in an oven, this big giant oven. And then afterwards they're taken out and they're sanded smooth. Well, the only reason they're sanded is because for people want that for whatever reason, like aesthetics. I think it looks better or whatever. It's just kind of tradition to sand the rods smooth. But what that does is take this really hard, shiny kind of, I call it a lacquer. I don't know if it's truly a lacquer, but it's the shell that's developed when the rod comes out of the oven, just naturally. And I don't know, I don't really understand the chemistry of it, I suppose. But when the rod is its strongest and toughest, is when it first comes out of the oven. This blank here. This is a composite blank, composite graphite and fiberglass, so it's extremely strong on its own. But then, instead of sanding the strength off of it, you know, this protective layer that's on top of the rod, so go ahead and just leave that on there and make the rod a lot stronger. So these rods are extremely strong just with the materials that they're made with and how they're built. But because this layer, what I call the tough skin, has not been sanded off, they're even stronger. So you could take a knife to this and it just won't scratch. Whereas you take a knife to this rod and it's going to scratch very easily. So a scratch is how rods become broken rods. They get a little nick in them. They're banging on the edge of your boat or wherever, and you get a little nick in it. And then all of a sudden, you set up on the fish or you get hung up and you pull back on it and like, oh, my rod broke. Well, it had a little scratch in it to start with. Because graphite is a lot like duct tape. The duct tape's extremely strong, but until you get a little tear in it, then it'll rip easy. Well, it's the same way with graphite. So that's why your rod broke when you pulled back on it real hard one time. You thought, oh, there's, you know, manufacturer defect. Like, well, probably not. It probably got a little scratch in it, and that's what happened. But these rods, though, because that layer is still on there, they're not going to scratch easily at all. So they're far more durable this way, and that's why I left them with this kind of a rough texture on them. So don't mean to be long-winded, but these rods are worth taking a second look at and understanding what exactly you're getting. So the 8 foot rods, one for 225, two for 415, four for 795. The 9 foot six, one for 230, two for 420, four for 800, minus 20% Saturday night special. That's a heck of a deal. And with the reels, if you need reels for your rods, I've got a pretty good supply of these Lexas now. You get free line. We'll go ahead and spool you up with whatever line you want, any of the P line here, braid or mono. We get 30-pound braid here. That's if you're kokanee fishing, I would, you know, probably go with that one, or the 50-pound. I kind of like the little heavier diameter for me, but most people like the 30-pound. But whatever line you want, if you want mono, that's fine. We'll spool it up for you for free. And you've got one heck of an awesome combo. So the special's on the rod, not the reel, but you do get free line with the reel, and you can't beat that. So be sure to subscribe, and we'll have some more specials for you in the future. And please come in the store if you can and take a close look at these rods for yourself.